I met a guy who used to be a baseball player. Like, for money.
That's cool. I used to love baseball. Was he good at it?
Don't know. We never got to play. He was good with a bat, though.
So I started my channel about 2016, and this was the first Walking Dead game I covered, The Walking Dead: A New Frontier. And this game does have a lot of meaning to me, despite, you know, how maybe it wasn't as good as other seasons. I still love the story, and I love the characters, and this was fantastic news that we've gotten. So a couple weeks ago, the creative director of the final season had confirmed that Javier and whatever determinant Garcia's you'd kept alive at the end of episode 5 from the gallows are alive. And now in this video, I will discuss this confirmation as well as the future. What we could get, potentially, if they decide to do a DLC or maybe even another season where we could maybe get a return of Javier as a playable character. Or maybe even, you know, where we run into him as a different character. Because again, after the final season ends, there's not going to be any more Clementine. So there is a possibility where we could get more Garcia family stuff. I would love to see it, and I think it's definitely possible. So if you guys enjoyed this video, make sure you smack a like, hit that sub. Let me know what you guys think of this news, and what would you like to see if they do end up returning in another season or a DLC. So let's get straight into all the news, and we'll catch y'all in the next one. Peace. So firstly, this is on the Tumblr of Kent Muddle, the creative director of the final season. And someone had asked him the following, named Badass Clementine 1. Are the Garcias okay? And he responded, "They're somewhere over there, safely off camera, where no tragic plot events can befall them." So this is confirmation that the Garcia family, whatever ones you have alive, as well as Javier, are alive, safe. Now, in episode 3, we had a mention of Richmond, and we also are going to get this McHale Ranch flashback mention explanation in episode 4, which will connect more about maybe they have a reason why Clementine didn't go back to Richmond. I talked about this, remember, see that AMA point right there on screen, where there was a reason Clementine did not go back to Richmond. And what was that reason? And I think in episode 4 with this ranch and everything that happened at, we will get that confirmation. So let us talk about first that episode 3 mention, and then we'll go on to the potential future.
You don't know what it's like out there. It's a bloodbath. One community against another, from Richmond to the coast. Back at the Delta, we're at war with some really sick fucks who make me look like the Virgin Mary. We need people to fight it.
And Abel describes a bloodbath from one community from Richmond to the coast, and that basically gave me the confirmation that Richmond is around as well. So it's most likely that the Garcia family is still in Richmond. And that is awesome to hear. Now, is Richmond directly involved with the Delta or this group community in the North? I believe not, but they are a big enough relevant community to be mentioned by Abel, and he basically calls these sick Fs. This group of the North must really be effed, man, whoever they are, whoever they're led by. He called them sick Fs who make him look like the Virgin Mary. That's pretty strong, and that we'll talk more about this group of the North and, you know, this Delta War more in another video, but Richmond, probably going to be around. The future, though, is something I really want to talk about. This is mainly the topic. With the confirmation of the Garcias being alive and Richmond still most likely being around, we could still potentially get another Walking Dead story, especially with the McHale Ranch flashback or, you know, answer that we're going to be getting in episode 4. We should have a reason now. We should know why Clementine never went back. And maybe that'll connect with Garcia's a little bit. But remember, we're not going to be seeing them in the final season. So could we potentially get a DLC slash a spinoff series with the Garcias? I think it's possible. And I think once episode 4 ends, they're going to be... Skybound Games, I think, is definitely going to consider making another Walking Dead season or another Walking Dead DLC, some kind of spinoff. I definitely think if the final season... final episode is very popular and they get a lot of sales with it and it does well, I think they can consider making something else to it. But that's all dependent on how things go with the final episode. I definitely do think the final episode, the hype behind it so far, you guys have seen how well some of my videos have done. There's a lot of hype behind this final episode, so I'm confident that it will do well. Now, what a potential DLC story I'd like to see with the Garcias is that we either get some kind of DLC that's staged in Richmond, maybe, if the McCurry Ranch is connected with it. Maybe we get an explanation of what happened maybe in the couple years time skip since season 3 and season 4. Or maybe we get a, you know, new season with the Garcias, and maybe we get more of a connection with the Delta, with the group in the north. I like to see if we can maybe get another season with the Garcias, but we're fighting this group in the north or the Delta, and we get to finally learn the backstory of the Delta. Who's their main leader? Why are they kidnapping kids? Who's this group in the north? Who's their main leader? Why are they fighting the Delta? I think they can easily make another story with the Delta, group in the north, and Richmond. Put them all together and see, you know, maybe have them all fight each other. I would love to see it. I think that would be something a lot of fans would like, because I don't think in the final episode of the final season they're going to be explaining the Delta as much, because remember, the boat exploded and Lily's plan basically failed, so we're not going to be going back to the Delta, and I don't think we're going to be running into this group in the north unless it's somewhere near the end of the episode, and I don't think that's going to happen either. So I would like to see either that or a potential maybe where we're another group and we run into Javier. Maybe Javier is a side character again and we run into him with another group. Maybe we play as someone in another Walking Dead season in the Delta or in the group in the north, and we get to find out more about either one. I would love to see that. I think they build up a big enough story here to where they could continue it on in some kind of passion. Unless episode 4 really goes into this Delta or group of the north and gets a big explanation on them. I think they have enough backstory there to where I'd be interested to have a season revolved around this, because it has a backstory with Clementine and all that, and you know, this entire story with the boarding school kids. So that's all I really want to talk about, guys. We'll talk about more about potentialities of DLC, Javier, and all that in another video, probably after episode 4 releases, because that's when really when I want to talk about this kind of stuff. But the Garcias are confirmed alive, and as well as Richmond, and we will probably learn more about it once we get this McCurry Ranch information in episode 4. So let me know what you guys think of this down below in the comments. Let me know if you guys want to see Garcias again in another DLC or another season, if they end up doing one. And one thing, y'all so much for watching, and we'll catch y'all in the next one. Peace.